Remember that his time has expired.
I call to Uru Flavel.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Greetings to us in this House of Parliament this night. I come to this bill on behalf of the party, and firstly acknowledging the passing of Raiha Mahuta. She was a good example of guardianship, and her role was to look after the budget and to guide the Tainui people, and she received the limits. And just to follow on from Tariana Turia, I send my sympathies and extend my pay tribute to her. She lays on her marae at Wahi Marae, and later on she'll be taken back to her birthplace in Northland. So I say, lay, rest in peace, respected elder. Soon you will arrive and be with your husband, Bob Mahuta. To all the living, I greet you. Mr. Speaker, it's not as though I'm an expert on these things, finances. But I speak about what I see and what I hear, and in the Select Committee, Commerce Select Committee, just in the months that have passed, what I saw was the pain of the people that arrived at that committee hearing and laying down their sadness at people who have been affected by this bill. I could see the elders who arrived before the committee with their anger, their sadness at the devious work of others. And that's all I'm saying is what I saw. I put that there. I come back now to a queer Edia Few. She's been involved in a group formed as a group exposing unacceptable financial activities, exposing exposing unacceptable financial activities in an organisation set up to seek out victims of financial abuse by irresponsible financial advisors. Their mission is to bring people power to the industry and demonstrate the human devastation caused by unacceptable financial activities. As part of their driving mission, they seek also to expose those who are responsible for the finance company collapses and the crisis this has caused. This is about I want to acknowledge that group and the commitment of individuals who have continued to bring these issues to our attention. I acknowledge this group and the commitment of individuals who have continued to bring these issues to our attention despite their own personal situations. These are people who had little hope of ever retrieving their funds. We must recognise their work, as well as the sacrifice of so many New Zealanders whose livelihoods have been threatened by shonky advice and distributor advisors. So I want to recognise this, their work. Because of the shonky advice and distributable advisors, This bill demonstrates they have succeeded in their mission to protect the interests of investors and enhance investor confidence in financial markets. Mr. Speaker, the bill will require people who want to be a trustee, a statutory supervisor, or unit trustee to be competent and effective in their function and to be held accountable for failing to perform their function effectively. If they're effective, then get rid of them. If they are not going to perform, and the real, they need to have the knowledge and experience as trustees. This bill fits in to a suite of legislation which the Māori Party has previously supported. Other similar legislation which we have supported has sought to improve standards, competency and confidence in those with advisory and supervisory roles in financial markets. There are some key issues that we hope will be flushed out during the Select Committee stage of this bill. And this is the beauty of going to Select Committee stage. Many will arrive and speak their concerns. In particular, we are interested in understanding how the bill will affect Māori and iwi trust, Māori or iwi trust. The Minister talked earlier today about stringent monitoring requirements. Our interest is knowing how this will impact on their continuing ability to carry out the role. We are also interested to learn more about whether the competency issues or the lack of sound knowledge in trust management that appears in this bill. It appears this bill has emerged in response to. Mr. Speaker, in reality, one of the things that is often said about Māori and iwi trust is that they tend to be, if anything, risk averse. Most Māori landowners owners are often conservative and risk averse, particularly when there's a chance that land might be lost at risk of being lost. And that's why it's a good thing this has been coming out in front of the Select Committee. And this is the idea of this bill, to look deeply at some of the issues. And Māori don't want to just waste their money. They need to closely look at the guardians of land trusts. Something I forgot. Many of the landowners believe that organisations should place as much importance on their social and cultural objectives, and it would be usual for Māori Trust to avoid making any financial decisions which would jeopardise the security of these key stakeholders. This is enough for now. The Māori Party supports the first reading of this bill as it goes to the Select Committee. So whānau, hapū and iwi can hear clearly the issues and be able to lay their own concerns before the committee. I call Melissa.